5 uninhabited places on the planet that will be habitable in 100 years. The human race is capable of adapting to the most difficult and dangerous environments on the planet. However, despite our impressive ability to adapt, there are areas of the planet so inhospitable that humans can only visit for a couple of days but not stay there for a long time. These are places where it is not possible to find the most basic resources such as water or food to sustain a large population. However, the effects of global warming and climate change are changing the rules of the game. And because of that, many places that today are almost completely uninhabited by humans will become large populations in 100 years. Do you want to know what those places are and how they will become habitable places? Stay with us to find out. Number 5. Canadian Arctic. The Canadian Arctic is a vast and remote region covering more than 2 million square kilometers. It's made up of frozen tundra, glaciers, and ice-covered seas. The region is home to about 15,000 people, most of whom are members of isolated indigenous communities, such as the Inuit. Many of these communities have developed nomadic ways of life adapted to one of the harshest environments on the planet, where temperatures can drop below minus 50 degrees Celsius in winter, and access to basic resources is extremely limited. This, combined with the difficulty of maintaining living crops, the lack of infrastructure, and the extreme distance from the rest of the world's cities, has contributed to the Canadian Arctic being one of the least populated regions on Earth. However, global warming is causing accelerated melting in the Canadian Arctic, opening up new possibilities for colonization and resource exploitation due to the creation of new trade routes. According to recent studies, such as those carried out by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the IPCC, the Arctic is expected to experience warming of up to 8 degrees Celsius by the end of the 21st century. This will result in the significant reduction of sea ice and the thawing of permafrost in large areas, which would allow new marine trade routes to be opened. Dr. John England, a leading scientist in Arctic geosciences, has pointed out that this melting can expose lands previously covered in ice, making them potentially habitable. When the lands are bare of ice, it will be easier to access the mineral, oil, and gas resources known to be abundant in this region. This would mean that in 100 years, this region will be a great attraction for governments and fuel companies, which would encourage the arrival of workers with families who would settle in these new ice-free territories with more pleasant temperatures than today. According to scientific projections, there is a high probability that this region will see considerable population growth if current trends continue. If this colonization process materializes, the world could face a significant change in population distribution and resource use. The Arctic, once considered a frozen desert, could become a new front for human expansion, with both ecological and geopolitical implications. This would upend the natural balance of a region that has remained relatively untouched for millennia. Number 4. Eastern Siberia. Eastern Siberia is a vast region that stretches from the Ural Mountains to the Pacific Ocean. It is one of the most inhospitable and least populated territories on the planet. Covering an area of more than 10 million square kilometers, East Siberia is home to approximately 8 million people, mainly concentrated in small towns and widely dispersed indigenous settlements such as the Yakut or the Evenki. These people still maintain a traditional lifestyle, and some are even still nomads and reindeer herders. Considering how immense the region is, the population density is extremely low. The main reason is its extreme climate. Winters are long and severe with temperatures that can drop below minus 40 degrees Celsius, and some areas such as Yakutia even drop below minus 60 degrees Celsius, while summers are short and relatively cool. The vast expanse of permafrost covering much of the region presents additional challenges, such as soil instability, making it difficult to build and develop infrastructure. In addition, East Siberia's distance from the major urban and economic centers of Russia and the world has kept it isolated and with limited economic development. However, climate change is beginning to transform the Siberian landscape. According to recent studies, such as those from the Potsdam Institute for Climate Research, global warming is reducing permafrost and increasing winter temperatures, which could make East Siberia more accessible and habitable in the coming decades. Professor Vladimir Romanovsky, a leading scientist in the study of permafrost, has pointed out that thawing permafrost may open up new areas for agriculture and mining, sectors that could attract significant migration to the region in the next 100 years. The availability of previously frozen land, together with a more temperate climate, would facilitate the expansion of agriculture, the exploitation of natural resources, and the development of infrastructure, which could lead to considerable population growth. In fact, the city of Chukotka, one of the first autonomous districts of the Russian Federation, recently acquired a floating nuclear power plant. This plant will supply energy to the city for the next 40 years and considerably increase the number of people who can live in this remote city, located in one of the coldest places in the world. It is expected that in the coming years, the regions of Kola, Yamal, Yemir, and Kamchatka will also acquire their own floating nuclear power plants. In addition, global warming will make the Arctic Sea an important trade route, so it is possible that in 100 years, this remote region of the planet will become the next industrial pole of the world, since it is located near the emerging markets of East Asia. An increase in the population of Eastern Siberia would have a significant overall impact. This region could become a new hub of agricultural production and resources, helping to ease pressures on agricultural land in other parts of the world that will be affected by climate change. In addition, human expansion into Siberia could change geopolitical dynamics, with Russia playing an increasingly important role in the global economy and trade as this region thaws. Number 3. Rub al-Khali Desert, Arabian Peninsula. Also known as the Empty Room, is the world's largest continuous sand desert, covering approximately 650,000 square kilometers in the Arabian Peninsula. This vast dunes and sandy terrain expanse spans Saudi Arabia, Oman, the United Arab Emirates, and Yemen. Today it is one of the most inhospitable and desolate regions on the planet, with temperatures that can exceed 55 degrees Celsius in summer and almost no annual precipitation. Due to these extreme conditions, the human population in Rub al-Khali is virtually non-existent. The only people who inhabit its surroundings are small Bedouin communities, which have historically been nomadic and adapted to life in the desert. Almost no people live in Rub al-Khali mainly because of the extreme aridity and high temperatures, which make human life unsustainable without constant access to water and resources. In addition, the lack of infrastructure such as roads, electricity, and communication systems further limits the possibility of large populations settling in this region. However, climate change and technological advances could transform this perception. According to recent studies, such as those conducted by the King Abdulaziz City for Science and Technology in Saudi Arabia, changes in global weather patterns could cause parts of the Rub al-Khali to experience a slight increase in humidity and a decrease in extreme temperatures towards the end of the 21st century. This phenomenon, combined with innovations in desalinization technologies and renewable energy, could make this region more livable. Professor Abdullah Al-Ghamdi, an expert in desert climatology, has suggested that developing solar energy technologies and constructing desalinization plants could allow currently uninhabited areas such as the Rub al-Khali Desert to become densely populated within 100 years. Advances in agriculture in arid environments such as hydroponics can also allow communities to settle in the desert to take advantage of its vast solar resources. Studies that project the rise of technology and the need to explore new territories due to global population growth support this likelihood. If Rub al-Khali were to start populating, we would see a significant change in the region's economic and demographic dynamics. Transforming this desert into a habitable area could ease pressure on the already densely populated urban areas of the Arabian Peninsula and position the region as a leader in renewable energy and sustainable technology. Number 2. Sahara Desert, Central Region. It is located in North Africa, the world's largest hot desert, covering approximately 9.2 million square kilometers. The Central Sahara region, known for its vast dunes, rocky plains, and volcanic mountains, is one of the most inhospitable areas on the planet. Temperatures in this region can reach 50 degrees Celsius during the day and drop sharply at night. Precipitation is virtually non-existent, with less than 25 millimeters of rain annually in some areas. Due to these extreme conditions, the Central Sahara region is almost uninhabited, with only a few nomadic Tuareg and Berber communities moving across the desert and temporarily settling in regions with access to water. Survival in this region depends on groundwater sources such as oases and a deep cultural adaptation to desert conditions. But severe natural restrictions have limited human development in this vast area. Climate change and technological advances could transform this reality in the next 100 years. A study from the University of Maryland suggests that fluctuations in global weather patterns could lead to a slight increase in humidity in some parts of the Central Sahara. Although this change would not turn the desert into a humid region, it could make certain areas more habitable, especially with the support of advanced technologies such as water desalinization and solar energy. Professor Michael Sivak, an expert in renewable energies, has highlighted the potential of the Sahara to become a center for solar energy production, given its constant exposure to the sun and its extensive uninhabited areas. In the next century, the Central Sahara may begin to attract more people, mainly due to the development of energy infrastructure and access to clean water through desalinization and groundwater extraction. The establishment of large solar plants could provide not only energy, but also jobs and an economic boost that could encourage migration to the region. If this trend materializes, Central Sahara could experience a significant shift in its demographics and economy. The possibility of turning one of the most inhospitable deserts into a center of human and technological activity could relieve pressure on other, more densely populated regions and contribute significantly to the global production of renewable energy. However, the viability of these changes depends, to a large extent, on technological investments and the management of sustainable water resources in the region. Number 1. Inner Greenland. Inner Greenland is a vast region mostly covered by an ice sheet that spans approximately 1.7 million square kilometers and accounts for 80% of Greenland's surface. This ice sheet is the second largest in the world after Antarctica, and its average thickness reaches 2,135 meters, with points where it exceeds 3,000 meters. The current situation in inland Greenland is extremely inhospitable, with winter temperatures dropping below minus 50 degrees Celsius and summer temperatures rarely exceeding 0 degrees Celsius. These severe conditions, coupled with the lack of accessible natural resources and infrastructure, mean that there are almost no permanent inhabitants in the interior of Greenland. Greenland's population is mainly concentrated in coastal areas, where approximately 56,000 people, mostly Inuit, live in small communities. However, the island's interior is practically uninhabited due to the extreme conditions and the impossibility of developing sustainable economic activities in such a hostile environment. However, the effects of climate change are beginning to transform Greenland in significant ways. Global warming has accelerated the melting of the Greenland ice sheet, which could have geopolitical and environmental consequences for decades. According to a study published in Nature by climate scientist Jason Box of the Geological Survey of Denmark and Greenland, GEUS, if current trends continue, Greenland could experience substantial melting of its ice sheet over the next century, which could expose vast areas of land that are now entirely covered in ice. Over a 100-year horizon, parts of inner Greenland may begin to become habitable for humans, especially if ice melt continues at the projected rate. The exposed areas could be mined and used for geothermal energy, which would establish new communities, although this would also entail significant ecological challenges. In addition, Greenland could become a center of global economic interest due to its vast mineral resources, which are currently inaccessible under the ice. If inland Greenland begins to be populated, it could significantly alter global economic and political dynamics. It would also generate new tensions regarding the exploitation of resources in this region, since it is known that, just as in Antarctica and Siberia, in Greenland there are also oil deposits under the ground, and many countries will want to have control over these for their own benefit. The likelihood of this scenario occurring is increasingly plausible, supported by scientific studies that underscore the acceleration of climate change and its impacts on the polar regions. As we have seen, many regions that are practically uninhabited today will have large agglomerations of people and small cities in the future, either because climate change will make them have a more pleasant climate, or because global warming will help vast regions that are currently covered with ice in the future to no longer be so and instead be accessible to established cities. But the question that remains is, will populating these areas, which have remained completely free from human activities for thousands of years, be beneficial or harmful to the environment? Now we want to hear your opinion. Tell us, what other regions of the world do you think should go on this list? Do you think that inhabiting these areas that are currently uninhabited will be beneficial for nature and ecosystems? Let us know what you think in the comments.